Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. This is Anthony Vijay. Today we are going to discuss about introduction to Java programming. So let me see the agendas of today's session. Now, first of all, we shall understand how it is named as Java and where Java is used for and exactly what Java is. Thereafter, features of Java and finally components of Java. So let me see one by one. First of all, we will be going to see about how it is named as Java. The Java language was initially called as Oak because Oak Tree was outside of Gosling's office. Later, the project went by the name Green. After that, Gosling's friend Arthur Van Hoff, Andy Pecher, came to the project and it was finally renamed as Java from Java office. It's a type of coffee from Indonesia. So Gosling designed Java in the form of C, C++ syntax. He was developed Java in the year of 1995. And there are more than 3 billion of devices running Java. So next we are going to see about where Java is used for. So I have listed out some of the applications that uses Java. So here I am going to give some short summary of everything. First of all, banking. In banking, Java deals with transaction management. So next one is retail. So it's like billing applications that you see in a store or restaurant are completely written in Java. The next one is information technology. Java is designed to solve implementation dependencies. Next one is Android. Android is an application can be written in Java or Java API. So next one is financial service. So Java can be used in server-side applications for financial services. And it can also be used for stock markets also. When I talk about stock market, we can write algorithms to which company should you invest in. The next one is big data. So Hadoop MapReduce framework is written using Java. The last one is scientific and research community. So in Java, it deals with a huge amount of data to do some research activities. There is no end for Java. So let's see some of the technologies that make use of Java. So here I am mentioning some of the technologies. For example, when we take web development, for web development purpose, we are having a lot of framework we are having. So first one is AngularJS. It's a toolkit for building application development. And when I talk about Node.js, it is used in developing network applications. So at the same time, we need Selenium also for web development. It's a framework for testing web applications. And Java can be used for Android applications and it can be available in Play Stores. And finally, big data. So Java deals with a large amount of data through Hadoop library framework. It deals with large amount of data. So these are the technologies Java involved in. Next, we are going to see about what is Java. So Java is an object-oriented programming language that is similar to C++. And it is having a lot of advanced and very, very simplified features. And it is open source. It means you can run on all the platforms. So Java has a lot of characteristics. The first characteristic is concurrent, where you can execute many statements parallelly. The next one is class-based and object-oriented. So when I talk about class-based and object-oriented, it is an object-oriented programming language. And the next one is independent programming language. So it follows write once and run everywhere. That is, compiled code can run on all the platforms which supports Java. So next one is feature. Feature makes a language so attractive. So let me see the features of Java. There are a lot of features in Java. We will see one by one. The first feature is simple. It means simplicity. Java has made life easier by removing all the complexities such as pointers, operator overloading, as you see in C++ or any other programming language. So next one is portable. This is a platform independent, which means that any application written in one platform can easily port it to another platform. And the next one is object oriented. Everything is considered to be an object which possesses some state, behavior, and all operations are performed using these objects. So next one is secured. So secure is a very, very important feature. All the code is converted into bytecode after compilation, which is not readable by the human. It is used to prevent any activities from untrusted sources. It means it will not allow any unauthorized persons. And it enables to develop virus-free and tamper-free systems and applications. So next one is dynamic. So it has the ability to adapt to evolve environment, which supports dynamic memory allocations. Due to that, which memory wastage will be reduced and the performance of the application is increased. So dynamic is also very, very important feature. Next one is distributed. This language provides a feature which helps to create distributed applications. Using the remote method invocation, a program can invoke a method of another program across a network. This is what distributed. So Java can support to create distributed applications. Next one is robust. Robust means Java has a strong memory management system. It helps in eliminating error. It checks a code during compile and runtime process. When I talk about high performance, Java achieves high performance through the use of bytecode, which can be easily translated into native machine code. So next one is interpreted. So Java is compiled to bytecodes, which are interpreted by a runtime environment. And the last one is multi-threaded. This is very, very important for doing graphics programming. So Java supports multiple thread of execution, including set of synchronization primitives, and it will be very, very helpful for creating graphics programming and all. Okay. So these are the features of Java. So next we are going to see about components of Java. So there are three components like Java Virtual Machine, Java Runtime Environment, and Java Development Kit. So these are the three important components of Java. So let me see one by one. So when I talk about Java Virtual Machine, it is an abstract machine. It is a specification that provides a runtime environment in which the bytecode can be executed. This is what Java Virtual Machine. When I talk about Java Runtime Environment, JRE is a short form of runtime environment. So JRE refers to a runtime environment in which a bytecode can be executed. It implements the JVM and provides all class libraries and other supportable files that uses JVM at the runtime. JRE is useful for JVM. Okay, all three components are interconnected. And the last one is Java Development Kit. So the Java Development Kit is completely includes JRE, which contains tools for programmers. The development kit is provided free of charge. It means free, freely available. It includes interpreter, loader, compiler, archiver, documentation generator, and other tools are available in the documentation. So in short, we can say Java Development Kit contains JRE and development tools. So this is what components of Java. So hereby I conclude my session. So far we have discussed about how it is named as Java and where Java is used for and exactly what is Java and thereafter features of Java, and finally we have discussed about components of Java. In the upcoming session we will be going to see about basic concepts of Java programming. So guys, if you are having any queries in this session, just mention in the comment box. I will clarify your doubts. If you want to take any topic, just mention in the comment box. I will cover in the upcoming session. Please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you very much for watching.